Imagine the following scenario. You and a group of friends come up with an idea that you're sure is going to be a huge hit. You're so sure, in fact, that you round up money from all your pals and family and even get a few investors, and you pour thousands upon thousands of dollars into turning this idea into a reality. Finally, after years of researching, developing, and perfecting your idea, it's finished. So what do you do now? The only logical answer is to give it away for free. And that's the business model surrounding free-to-play video games. Companies spend a ridiculous amount of time and money to create a finished product and then let the consumer play it for free. So here's the question. How does a free game make money? Some games turn to premium memberships, giving players access to the content they otherwise wouldn't be able to consume. Some provide cosmetics, like character skins, announcer voiceovers, and other special effects. But some, especially bigger companies, push the boundaries of what is acceptable in a free-to-play environment. Think EA with FIFA Ultimate Team and Star Wars Battlefront 2 loot boxes. Well, on November 29th, 2017, another game decided to push those boundaries a little too hard. Enter Paladins, a free-to-play game developed by Hi-Rez Studios. In 2017, the developers decided to change up one of Paladin's fundamental gameplay features, a decision which set the gaming community on fire. In this video, we'll be looking at how Paladins tried to implement a pay-to-win system, but were ultimately beaten down by community backlash. This is Paladins, Cards Unbound. Paladins is a hero shooter. If you've ever played Team Fortress 2 or Overwatch, you'll probably have a good idea of what that entails. For those of you who don't know, a hero shooter is an objective-based shooting game where two teams vie for supremacy on different maps. What sets the genre apart from regular shooting games is the inclusion of heroes or champions who have different roles and abilities. Sort of like a MOBA or RPG, different characters are designed to fill different positions, such as frontline tanks, damage dealers, flankers, and supports, and have stats and skills that reflect their role in a team composition. Where Paladin sets itself apart from other hero shooters is in its card loadout system. In a typical hero shooter, character stats are a set constant, meaning that if a character's regular attacks do 100 damage, that value remains the same for everyone. But in an effort to give players more variance in their playstyle, Paladins employs a stat loadout system with cards that allows you to customize your character and playstyle. How it works is that before a game, you're able to equip your champion with a loadout of 5 cards that have a variety of effects, ranging from stat boosts to unlocking new abilities. This is combined with the Paladin's talent system, which lets you pick one of 3 character-specific talents that can completely change how your character is played. The card system was generally beloved by Paladin's players, as more options means no 2 games play the same. The card system was one of Paladin's main features that set it apart from the competition.
So a card system, which I really dig,
reminds
right?
Reminds me of Paragon.
Yeah, so you can choose your different layouts, right? And you can kind of put points on those cards.
Absolutely.
So they can be stronger.
Yep.
However, this is when Hi-Rez decided to take cards in a not-so-beloved direction. On November 29th, 2017, the Paladin's YouTube channel released a dev update video announcing Cards Unbound, a brand new leveling system that replaced the old card points distribution system. Now, instead of all cards being created equal, each card had its own progression system, allowing players to level up their cards to make them better. Under the new system, players would acquire duplicates of cards in order to level them up, with the number of duplicates required to max out a card depending on the card's rarity. Also announced was that any purchase of the loot boxes to upgrade cards would only be purchasable with in-game currency, and not with premium funds that cost real-world money. However, it was quickly discovered that the Cards Unbound system was not as fair as Hi-Rez had implied. Previously, players could craft cards specifically for certain characters, allowing them to focus on those they played and ignore those that they didn't. But with Cards Unbound, the system became completely randomized, meaning that players would have to open loot boxes and pray, rather than just craft the cards they needed with essence. On top of this, once you finally found the card you were looking for, you'd still have to level it up to unlock its full potential, as a level 1 card is drastically less powerful than the same card at level 5. While Hi-Rez insisted that this system was geared towards getting new free-to-play players into the action, critics were quick to point out that Cards Unbound had some striking similarities to Star Wars Battlefront 2's predatory loot boxes, and that those who spent the money to get level 5 cards had a distinct advantage over those who did not. Before we go any further, now is probably a good time to point out that Cards Unbound was game mode specific. For example, in ranked play, all cards were set to level 3, to ensure that competitive play was based solely on player skill. However, the new Quick Play mode had no restrictions on card costs, meaning that a player could use 5 level 5 cards against new players who only had level 1s. This imbalance was a huge point of contention, as casual game modes are where players go to either practice new champions or just have fun with their friends. Unfortunately, it's difficult to practice or have any fun at all when you're getting stomped by players with fully kitted decks. So players were faced with a dilemma. Spend hours upon hours grinding for in-game currency, spend what little you earned on a loot box, and pray that that loot box gives you the right card, or spend some money and get the loot box for virtually no effort. And in case you were wondering, to get a single common card from level 1 to level 5 required a whopping 42 cards. Now multiply that by the 271 common cards that were in the game at the time, and you're gonna have to open a lot of loot boxes to get what you need. The result was a long, drawn-out debate between players and Hi-Rez, with each unable to accept the other's decisions. While players wanted the Cards Unbound system completely removed from the game, Hi-Rez opted only to tweak it, a far cry from fixing the unbalanced mechanic. The discourse spilled over from Reddit to news sites like Kotaku and IGN, and was yet another milestone in the ongoing issue of loot boxes in general. Fans even created their own form of protest by drawing poorly conceived caricatures of Paladin's characters in an effort to mock the developer's lack of care for the game. And as things were heating up, the pot finally boiled over when an IGN article came out highlighting the disconnect between the developers at Hi-Rez and their upper management. While executives at Hi-Rez were insistent that the Cards Unbound system was good for the game, the actual developers were not, as the unbalanced gameplay made Paladins almost unplayable for newcomers. When this inner turmoil was brought to light, Paladins executive producer Chris Larson announced that Cards Unbound would be removed from the game altogether. This news was met with excitement from players, but also criticism that it was too little too late. By the time the announcement was made in February of 2018, almost 4 months after Cards Unbound was released, Paladins had lost a lot of its player base, as Overwatch had established itself as the predominant game in the hero shooter genre. So the question remains, could Paladins have held on a little bit longer if its free-to-play rollout hadn't come with so much controversy? Maybe. Maybe not. But Paladins is an example of what happens when producers and developers can't agree on a common goal. On one hand, you have the developers, who want to make their game as fun as possible. And on the other hand, there are studio execs, who have to worry about quotas, shareholders, and making as much money as possible. Some games have found the middle ground between turning a profit and keeping their games inclusive, while others, like Hi-Rez and the Cards Unbound system, can push it a little bit too far and alienate the player base. But if there's one good thing that came out of this controversy, it's proof that we, as gamers and as a community, are able to come together and make our voices heard, and ensure that the games we play stay safe and fun for everyone. This video is made possible thanks to our wonderful patrons. Massive thank you to everyone on this list, and shout out to Arknox, Sammy, Shampoo, Weeboo, Nathan, Nate, Mauve, and Sierra for being Platinum supporters, and an extra special shout out to Raffy, Noodles, and Marco for being Diamond supporters. Thank you so much, guys. It means a lot. And an extra special shout out to Undead Streaming for being our Grandmaster supporter. Thanks again to everyone on this list. If you also want to support our channel and unlock perks, check out the Patreon link in the description below or join our Discord server. If you want to help out in a different way, leaving a like, subscribing, and hitting the bell to stay up to date is also appreciated. My name is Jonah. Thanks for watching.